Hello everybody, this is the Structures Guy, and today we're talking about the new record holder for the longest suspension bridge in the world as measured between its two towers. Located approximately 210 kilometers west of Istanbul, Turkey, the 1950 Çanakkale Bridge has a total length of 4,608 meters. The year 1915 in the bridge name honors the Ottoman naval victory against the British and the French during World War I. The bridge cost approximately 2.5 billion euros to build and was opened to traffic on the 18th of March 2022. The Turkish President Erdogan said that he expects a big return when it comes to fuel consumption, as much as 415 million euros saved per year. Since 1994, it was a long-standing dream of Turkey to cross the Dardanelles Strait in Turkey using a suspension bridge. Now, the travel time to cross the strait, which used to take at least an hour and a half on ferries, will be cut down to only 6 minutes. Prior to the 1915 Çanakkale Bridge being built, the suspension bridge with the longest span in the world was the Akashi Kaikyo Bridge in Japan. It has a total length of 3,911 meters and a main span of 1,991 meters. In addition to beating the Akashi Kaikyo Bridge in total length, the 1915 Çanakkale Bridge also beats it in the longest main span, with a distance between the towers of 2,023 meters. The length honors 2023 as Turkey's 100-year anniversary after the ending of the Ottoman Empire. In line with the other symbolic elements of the bridge, the height of its towers, which is 318 meters high, is meant to represent the date March 18th, which marks the day on which Turkey remembers naval losses at Gallipoli during World War I. However, the height of the tower has engineering significance. As the span gets longer, the forces and dimensions of the bridge increase, so the tower need to be taller to support the cables. Here is a quick overview of the bridge construction schedule. On the 18th of March 2018, the first pile was driven into the seabed. By the 9th of May 2019, both the Asian and European caissons steel shaft installation were complete. By the 26th of May 2019, the immersion of both caissons was completed. By the 21st of August 2019, first tower blocks for both the Asian and European towers were finished. On the 21st of December 2019, both towers have reached a height of 100 meters. The towers for both Asian and European sides were fully completed on the 16th of May 2020. On the 20th of May 2021, the installation of the main cables was completed. On the 7th of July 2021, hangar rods assembly was underway, and then deck installation was started shortly after that. By the 9th of August 2021, installation of the roadway 12th deck block was completed. Lastly, on the 24th of February 2022, asphalt works have been completed. A 6-month pandemic lockdown with extensive safety measures taken on site in 2020 delayed shipments of raw materials. However, the bridge opened 18 months ahead of schedule despite the delay caused by the pandemic. The bridge deck contains two stiffened closed steel box girders spaced 9 meters apart, connected by 3 meter wide cross girders every 24 meters. The gap between the two box girders ensures aerodynamic stability of the deck in very strong wind. The overall width of the twin box girders becomes 45 meters due to one maintenance walkway on each outer side. The bridge will carry 6 lanes, 3 in each direction. The twin box girder design reflects the advances in technology recently developed by the bridge engineers, as well as advanced materials like high-strength steel. The deck thickness of 3.5 meters is significantly thinner than the 14 meters thick deck of the Akashi Kaikyo Bridge in Japan. It is important to note that very large container and cruise ships will pass in the future, and the risk of ship impact is considered in the design. Today, more than 40,000 vessels pass every year, and that is expected to increase significantly in the one-year bridge design life. The Turkish fought against the Australians and British in World War I, but 100 years later, they worked hand-in-hand with many Australians and British pledge to build this bridge. More than symbols, officials hope that the bridge will stimulate local and international economic development, logistics, and tourism. It may be that engineers are starting to approach the limit for span lengths for a traditional suspension bridge, but many engineers are looking into modified shapes and structural arrangements. One alternative is a hybrid suspension and cable-stayed bridge. Sturdier than suspension alone, a solution like this may be the answer to build even longer bridges in the future. This bridge is a marvelous structure in terms of design and construction. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something from it. See you next time.